Thank you. John Williams, who's a very prolific composer. He's still living, he's still continuing to work on the Star Wars movies, but we're going to play a medley of pieces from his movies, and that's right now. This is called The Marches of John Williams.
Thank you. Well, I think it's great to get to read it to all of you, but this is really a story to be told to kids. So I think I have some high school kids out in the audience that if I can have them come join me, any of the high school kids, or any little kids at all that would like to join me. What's that? I'm not really a hat person.
Well, it's
covering. What? Oh. Are you saying I don't have any hair? Is it hard for you guys to read the music with the glare? Alright. It's supposed to get cold tonight, so I guess I'll wear it. Not cold enough that we won't have school tomorrow, no.
Mm-hmm.
A bundle of toys he had flung on his back, and he looked like a peddler just opening his pack. His eyes, how they twinkled, his dimples, how merry. His cheeks were like roses, his nose like a cherry. His droll little mouth was drawn up like a bow, and the beard of his chin was as white as the snow. The stump of a pipe he held tight in his teeth, and the smoke it encircled his head like a wreath. He had a broad face and a little round belly that shook when he laughed like a bowl full of jelly. He was chubby and plump, a right jolly old elf, and I laughed when I saw him in spite of myself. A wink of his eye and a twist of his head soon gave me to know I had nothing to dread. He spoke not a word, but went straight to his work, and filled all the stockings, then turned with a jerk, and laying a finger on the side of his nose, and giving a nod up the chimney he rose. He sprang to his sleigh, to his team gave a whistle, and away they all flew like the down of a thistle. But I heard him exclaim as he drove out of sight, "Happy Christmas to all, and to all a good night."
Thank you.